So Simply says, I'm having trouble leaving my emotionally unavailable boyfriend. I have so much resentment, yet it's difficult for me to leave him. Well, what you want to do, Simply Sinead, is that you want to have kind of a wake-up call. If you want to kind of put pressure on yourself, she says, I know we're not compatible, but every time I leave, I go through a lot of pain and end up getting back with him. Yeah, I mean, one of the things that you want to do is create a support network. Get out there, hang out. It depends on how you heal, right? So for a lot of people, it's getting out there and getting other people in their life, getting supportive people in their life, finding other men that, not necessarily that you're dating, but that can be supportive of you, finding women and loved ones that can be supportive of you, and taking a good look. And what, there's this exercise that you can do, and I think it's called like the Benjamin Franklin exercise. Everything's kind of like attributed to anything that's good that nobody knows where it came from, they attribute it to Ben Franklin. Anyway, there's so maybe that's what I'm doing right now. Anyway, there's a exercise out there, and what you can do is you take a piece of paper and you draw a line down the middle of the paper, and on one side put what kind of pain or loss that you end up experiencing by staying in your situation. And on the other side, what you want to put is the pleasure or the pain, or sorry, the pleasure or the benefits that you receive from getting out of the situation. And then just list on the left side all of the negative things that come from staying with him, right? So things that are going to be negative are going to be, one, you're probably never going to have the kind of relationship that you want. Two, you're never going to have a deep, passionate, emotional connection with a man. Three, you're going to be stuck with a man's potential because he's not going to be living up to who he wants to be or who you think he could be because he's so stuck in being emotionally unavailable. Three, you know, it's going to be embarrassing 10 years from now when you've spent, you know, a whole bunch of time in a relationship that was going nowhere and all your friends and family are like, you know, like, what are you doing? And you feel like, oh, I'm such a failure because I spent all this time. Anything that you can come up with, it might not necessarily be that, but anything that you can come up with that is pain from staying in your situation, and anything that you can come up with that's pleasure or benefit from leaving the situation, right? Like you're opening yourself up to more men. You're creating a life where you feel like you're valued and you're loved and you're appreciated. You're experiencing things that you wouldn't experience before because you're stuck in this negativity and anger and resentment, and you're opening yourself up to freedom and feeling alive and feeling beautiful and feeling life again. You know, and so you just want to go through those kinds of things and put those on a sheet of paper and then hang it up on your wall. And every time you think about getting back together with him, go over the list and really emotionalize the different things in the list until you're just like, you know what? Yeah, this sucks, but it doesn't suck as bad as going back to that dude, right? Because that sucks. So yeah, you want to associate him with pain and associate getting away from him with pleasure.